all this way. Well, just give me some head.
It's not like I'm letting aggression out, or I'm letting frustrations out, or I'm letting hatred out. It's just I'm doing something I want to do, you know.
I started surfing when we moved to Durban. I was about 10 years, just going on 10. And we saw these guys, we went down to the beach for the day and we saw these guys surfing. To me it looked like the best thing in the world, and you know, from that day on it was non-stop. I was 15 when I started surfing professionally. Hawaii is the kind of place where you have to go to, you know, experience the life of a surfer. If you don't sort of click in with Hawaii, then to be a successful professional surfer is going to be damn hard. The Pipe Masters contest, I ended up making it through to the semi-finals. Halfway through the heat, I got this wave that the set came through, and straight away I was just, you know, thrown off, freaked out, just going, oh no, I'm gonna die. It broke on the second reef, and Michael Ho looked at the wave like, this is it, you know, this is the perfect wave. And he sort of looked at me like I wasn't even there. I think that's what made me go for that wave, because there comes a time in everyone's life when you've got to put all your feelings, all your emotions aside and just go. And if you can't do that, then you know, it's going to take you a long time to get respect. If I had let that wave go, I think it would have taken at least 2 or 3 more years to get any kind of respect on the tour. My surfing is a reflection of my life, very up and down and very, very radical.
Natural talent pouring out his ears and his nose and his all orifices.
Martin Potter's surfing is really spectacular. He really turns me on.
Well, I tell you what, when Martin Potter takes off on a wave, you don't even know what he's gonna do.
It's the Harry.
Harry, that's a classic.
Well, it's pretty good.
Drifting on a sea of forgotten tears.
life goes.